That deadly shooting has cast a dark shadow just as the eyes of the world focus on New Zealand for the biggest women's sporting event on the planet. Police confirm three people are dead, including the gunman, and 10 others injured after the shooter, armed with a pump-action shotgun, stormed a building undergoing renovations in downtown Auckland. The gunman's been identified as 24-year-old Matu Tangi Reid, who was on home detention for violence offences, including male assaults female. He was wearing an electronic monitoring bracelet but had an exemption to work at the building site. The shooting occurred at this building in the CBD near the bottom of Queen Street by the city's major transport hub. We have extensive coverage this evening. The One News team standing by across the scene and at Eden Park, where the Women's Football World Cup is kicking off in just under an hour. We begin tonight with Barbara Drever, who's been covering the day's dramatic events since this morning.
Armed police storming a downtown construction site in search of a gunman on the loose. On the upper floors, workers hide from the shooter as he roams through the building.
We basically barricaded the door to the office we were sitting in and just started hiding under desks. We tried to run out. And he was still just standing in the staircase holding what looked like to be a shotgun.
Breakfast was live as rapid shots were fired.
It's happening. There are us. Oh, we can hear firing. We can hear gunshots coming from the building.
A worker could be seen running for his life. The gunman, who was barricaded in an elevator shaft, opened fire at police who shot back.
We heard shots fired like machine gun. Bam, bam, bam.
We were like really, really scared. Yeah, because you don't know where the bullet's going to come from and where it's going to go.
This police officer was one of 10 people injured, most of them taken to Auckland Hospital. Police found two bodies on the lower floors. Shocked survivors were evacuated from the building.
They're all being moved out really quickly. Ambulances are now being allowed to go in.
We were right at the entrance and I saw like 20 people rushing out of the building and telling the pedestrians to move. I was like, what happened? And I go ask them. They say like we saw a guy with a shotgun in his hand and he was aiming for people.
But it was hours before those taking shelter on the roof would be let down. The gunman was a 24-year-old on home detention for domestic violence-related charges.
However, he had an exemption to work at the site, and so there's no indication at this stage of a breach of those conditions.
The hotel construction site turned from an active situation to a crime scene.
We are very good at chaos. It's something that we don't like, but we are prepared for.
The world's best footballers shocked as they woke up in hotels surrounding the cordon. The day Auckland wanted to show off its best face to the world, starting with tragedy.
And Barbara's with us now live. Kia ora, Barb. You've just got new details about the gunman?
Yes, that's right. Corrections have confirmed that Matu Tangi Matua Reid was on home detention and he checked in with his probation officer just yesterday. Now, under the terms of his conditions, he was allowed to come to work to this hotel construction site behind me. He was an employee of a contractor there. Corrections say that he had completed drug and alcohol programs and he'd also been involved in an anti-violence program. Up until this morning, they say that they considered he'd done everything right, but they'll obviously be conducting a review into what's happened.
We saw in your report you were there as the shots rang out. Tell us what that was like.
Well, you can imagine, it was shocking for everyone outside. You can only imagine what it was like for those inside. And probably the worst thing was seeing the workers that sheltering behind pillars, and they were up against the windows and they had their arms around each other, supporting each other as obviously the active shooter went through that building. When they came out, I did speak to quite a few of those construction workers, most of them migrant workers, and they said they're okay, but you could tell from their faces they were pale, their hands they were shaking, and so you could tell that they're heavily traumatised by that event. Some were taken away by police, obviously witnesses, and their employer says they'll be putting in support measures to help them through this, what has been an extremely traumatic event.
Tēnā koe, Barb.